Here we go. It's time for Designated, the first pair out in the Morning Stock Eliminator. We have got a monster matchup, at least I think it is. We'll start out with Jeff Warren in his Copo Camaro. Jeff has been on Designated already. You know the drill for this bit. First out, you must love being on this little show.
I do love being on the show with you, but I'm not crazy about being a Designated pair every time. I just keep falling in there.
For those that don't know, the three slowest cars in qualifying and their pair on the ladder is how you become Designated. And so this matchup is going to be kind of fun. You've got an interesting opponent, the Dodge Caravan, turbo four-cylinder, front-wheel drive. You're going to have to wait a long time.
I am, but I'm ready. I've had a big spot before. I'm ready.
Okay, so how are you going to dial the car compared to how it's been running? You going to dial it honest, or are you going to try to play them down there?
Well, that's a pretty big advantage to try to play. That's a long spot, so I'm probably going to dial pretty honest. I can't get, when I catch him, it's going to be too late.
And I see a 10 on there. What's the dialing going to be?
10.02.
Okay, and what kind of mile per hour?
I'm going to be about 132.
Okay, that's what we're gonna hype. That's a big speed compared to what he's running. All right, good luck, Jeff.
Thanks, Joe. Y'all have a great day.
All right, let's go talk to Bill. Check it out, folks. Look at this race ride. The Dodge Caravan. This thing is mega. I think it's worthy of an attention in the pits, frankly. Bill Howell. Bill? All right. Here we go. Yeah. You're going to be first out on track. You're going to be first on track with this Dodge Caravan. We love this race machine. How are you going to handle running a 130-mile-per-hour car?
Well, it's going to be a tough race to judge. You know, both lights are green. I kind of hope they are, at least one side. And then, you know, on the other end, there's going to be some strategy about because, you know, it's really hard to judge a car running 30 miles an hour faster than you are, you know. So we're going to give it our best shot.
And what is the top speed in the Caravan?
90-something.
90-something. You got the kids in the back? Soccer ball?
Well, yeah, the ballast is back there, but we left them at home. So.
All right, so you're going to be first out, first pair. All right, do you know what your dialing is going to be?
1460-something. Okay. And his is like 10, you know, 4 seconds faster, so it'll be quite a spot.
This is what Stock Eliminator is all about. All right, good luck.
That's it. All right, thank you very much.
All right, here we go. It's Eliminations at Stock. It is Friday morning at Thunder Valley. The NHRA Thunder Valley Nationals day number 2 is officially underway. Oh, and a red light start. Bill Howell jumped the gun. Game over. Right here on the starting line. He clocked out early by 0.06 of a second. Jeff Warren tags the tree at 0.07, and he is driving down with a wind light already burning on top of that motor mile scoreboard.
All right, Jeff Warren had a 0.07, was 2 thou under, so he was going to be very tough. Bill Howell went red, but let's see if Jeff knew exactly how good he was. All right, Mr. Warren, tell us what you did without seeing the slip. What was your light?
He made it easy. I'm going to say I was 30.
All right, have a look at your slip.
Whew.
Yeah, good run. 0.07, 2 thou under the dial, and you got a good hot rod. Good luck today.
Yeah, after waiting that long, who knows what the light would have been. I mean, I kept thinking the tree ain't coming, you know, so, such a long spot.
Designated. Go get him. All right, let's speak with Mr. Howell. All right, Bill, you went red. You know that, but do you know what the number was, the red light? What do you think?
I don't have a clue.
All right. It was 063. There you go.
Okay.
And you're a couple over. You've been fighting the performance.
Yeah, you know, it's just one of those things. You know, Jeff's a tough competitor, and you got to give it what you can.
Your consolation prize is you get to be on attention in the pits.
Well, great. That's great.
See you at the pit. Good luck.
See you. All right. Thank you.
All right. Designated Mac, Big Neil Freeman, here we go, McNeil. You got Tyler Bohannon. He's good. He's fast. How are you going to handle it?
I am going to wear him out. The taxi is not looking back for him, so this is taxi time.
Taxi time. Hashtag taxi time, McNeil Freeman. All right, but you're going to be leaving first. He's going to be coming up fast. So you got a 1485 on there. How's that? Is that honest? Are you holding some? What are you doing?
I'm not honest, but we're just going to do the best we can at the finish line down there, but I do believe the wind light in my lane is coming on.
All right. We're going to find out. Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
All right, other side of the McNeil-Freeman matchup, Tyler Bohannon. This guy is tough, and obviously one of the Mosier machines that we know so well. We already talked to Mac. What is your plan in this race? How are you going to handle the strategy?
The strategy is kind of tough right here. You know, we got a big weather swing from yesterday, trying to figure that out. Looking at McNeil's runs, he didn't run the index yesterday, so that's kind of something tough we're trying to figure out. I know he's got a fast enough car to run the index, so I'm kind of in left field. I think I know what my car can run right here, so we're just going to dial it what I think it's going to run and just try to lay down our lap and let him do what he wants.
What is your dialing going to be?
1064, I believe.
All right, that is exciting. This guy's, it's a much slower car, which is very challenging on both drivers.
Yeah, it really is. The speed difference here should be 35-ish miles an hour, I believe, maybe 40. So that's something, it's not only hard for him to judge me, but it's extremely hard for me to judge him. So, like I said, I think the best strategy is just to try to dial my car to go dead on and just make the lap.
Good luck.
Thank you.
McNeil, a 4 Mississippi head start. Check it out. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4 Mississippi. Send the Corvette. Both drivers away on the green this time. McNeil is a long way down there. He's almost in Virginia. Here comes Tyler closing in with the Corvette. Can he catch him? Yep. 1067, 111 miles an hour. Predicted 64, ran a 67. That's a winner. McNeil was 15 flat at 85 miles an hour.
All right. Tyler Bohannon picked up the win, but how did you do it? Tell us your reaction time.
I'm going to go with 040. I think I missed it just a touch.
Close. Tell us.
30, 3 above. I knew I killed a little bit going through. He must, like I said, he missed his dial. He must have had a bad run or something yesterday because he dialed down a bunch. So, no, that's looks like we were going dead on. I'm pretty happy with that.
Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, let's go talk to McNeil. McNeil Freeman.
Good job, Tyler. It was fun. It was fun. But I tell you what, I definitely get it the next time. It's always the next time, guys. So I see him at Indy.
All right, but hey, you were in that race. You had a 79 light. The car didn't run the number. You've been chasing some stuff.
Absolutely. But yeah, I got it fixed. It'll be ready the next race.
Did you wear that hat when you raced?
I would like to, but they won't let me.
This is what NHRA drag racing is all about. Mac is going to go be the best fan we've got starting now. Good job.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Guys, have fun, because I am.